begin by offering our thanksgiving for the gift of holy baptism. Please rise as you are able. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the fountain of living water, the rock who gave us birth, our life, and our salvation.
Amen.
Joined to Christ in the waters of baptism, we are clothed with God's mercy and forgiveness. Let us give thanks for the gift of baptism. We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning you created us in your image and placed us in a well-watered garden. In the desert, you promised pools of water for the parched, and you gave us water from the rock. When we did not know the way, you sent the Good Shepherd to lead us to still waters. At the cross, you washed us from the disease and wounded side, and on the stage, you showered us again with the water of life. We praise you for your salvation through water, for the water in this fount, for the Delaware and Lehigh rivers, and for all water everywhere. Bathe us in your forgiveness, grace, and love. Satisfy all who thirst, and give us the life only you can give. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ, our living water, and give us the life only you can give in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
We gather to the song, we praise you, O God, ELW 870.
Thank you. Almighty God, our Father, your generous goodness comes to us new every day. By the work of your Spirit, lead us to acknowledge your goodness, give thanks for your benefits, and serve you in willing obedience. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
May be seated. Children, you may come forward for a little children's chat. Come on down. You know what Bob Barker used to say? Come on down. Come on down.
Hey. Hey. What's up, guys?
Yeah, just take a seat. It's okay. Let's go. Yeah. This Thursday is a very special day.
Huh?
Very special day?
What day is it?
Thanksgiving. We do something in our family that you probably do in your family too. Before we eat our big Thanksgiving meal, we go around and we say something we're thankful for. Something we're thankful for. What comes to your mind when you want to give thanks? Are there special things that you want to give thanks for? Anybody.
How about you? Anybody out here?
What do you want to give thanks for?
Thanks for grandchildren.
Thanks for the roof over our heads. Thanks, huh? Maybe we want thanks for all the food that's going to be on the table, right? Yeah, that's a good thanks. What about thanks for school? What about your dollar? Good thanks for your dollar. What about toys, games, fun times? Okay, those are all good things to give thanks for. There is a very special teacher, long time ago, 1,000 years ago. And he was asked, what's the best prayer? And he said, the only prayer you were ever to say is thank you. That would be enough. That would be enough. Because all our lives we give thanks to God. Right? Without whom none of this other stuff would even be here, right? Thank you, God. Thank you for being here. Yeah. And I'm thankful for each and every one of you. Thank you for being here today. Okay? You good? Ready to go? Ready to go? All right. Get out of here. We turn to the reading of the lesson.
To humble you and to test you, and in the end, to give you
good.
Do not say to yourself, my power and the might of my own hand have gotten me this wealth. But remember the Lord your God, for it is he who gives you power to get wealth, so that he may confirm his covenant that he swore to your ancestors, as he is doing today. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We will read responsively Psalm 65. You are to be praised, O God, in Zion. To you shall vows be fulfilled.
To you, the one who answers prayer, to you all flesh shall come.
Our sins are stronger than we are, but you blot out our transgressions.
I have your name, we choose to draw to your course to dwell there. They will be satisfied by the beauty of your house, by the holiness of your temple.
Awesome things will show us in your righteousness, O God of our salvation, O hope of all the ends of the earth and of the oceans far away.
You may confirm the mountains by your power. You are very high up in my
You still the roaring of the seas, the roaring of their waves, and the clamor of the peoples.
Those who dwell in the ends of the earth will tremble at the marvelous sons. You may have the dawn and the sun of the Lord.
You visit the earth, and water is abundant. You make it very plenteous. The river of God is full of water. You prepare your grain, for so you provide the earth.
You drench the furrows and smooth out the ridges. With heavy rain and softening ground, those are sinners.
You crown the year with your goodness, and your paths overflow with plenty. Shout for joy and sing. The second reading is from 2 Corinthians. The point is this: the one who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and the one who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. Each of you must give as you have made up your mind, not reluctantly or under compulsion. For God loves a cheerful giver. And God is able to provide you with every blessing in abundance, so that by always having enough of everything, you may share abundantly in every good work. As it is written, he scatters abroad, he gives to the poor, his righteousness endures forever. He who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food will supply and multiply your seed for sowing and increase the harvest of your righteousness. You will be enriched in every way. Your great generosity, which will produce thanksgiving to God through us, through the rendering of this ministry, not only supplies the needs of the saints, but also overflows with many thanksgivings to God. Through the testament of this ministry, you glorify God by your obedience to the confession of the gospel of Christ, and by the generosity of your sharing with them and with all others, while they long for you and pray for you because of the surpassing grace of God that he has given you. Thanks be to God for this is indescribable gift, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please rise for the gospel acclamation. Then one of them, when he saw that it was healed, turned back, praising God with a loud voice. He prostrated himself at Jesus' feet and thanked him. And he was a Samaritan. Then Jesus asked, "Were not 10 made clean? But the other 9, where are they? Was none of them found to return and give praise to God except this foreigner?" Then he said to him, "Get up and go on your way. Your faith has made you well." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
You may be seated. Dear friends in Christ, may the blessing of the Lord rest and remain upon you always for the sake of Jesus, the Messiah. Amen.
Amen.
The problem with most Thanksgiving sermons is that they just end up saying, "Be thankful for your blessings. Be thankful for your trials and tribulations. Be thankful for all your days, the good and bad alike. Be thankful." The problem, of course, is that telling people to be thankful is a little like telling them to be happy, cheer up, stop crying. True thankfulness comes from the heart. And unfortunately, our hearts don't just snap to the moment we command them to be this, that, or the other. The Bible takes a different approach to Thanksgiving. Rather than insisting on thankfulness, Scripture instead commands us to remember. The book of Deuteronomy is the Bible's book of remembrance par excellence. As the last will and testament of the prophet Moses, all of Deuteronomy is in large part a summons to remember. Remember that you were a slave in the land of Egypt. The Lord your God brought you out from there with a mighty hand and an outstretched arm. Do not be afraid of them. Just remember what the Lord your God did to Pharaoh and to all of Egypt. Remember the long way that the Lord your God has led you these 40 years in the wilderness. Remember and do not forget how you provoked the Lord in the wilderness. Remember today that it was not your children who have not seen or known the discipline of the Lord your God, but it is you who must acknowledge his grace. Remember the days of old. Consider the years long past. Ask your father, and he will inform you, your elders, and they will tell you. Deuteronomy assumes that without remembering what God has done, there is no thanksgiving for what God is doing. Without remembering God's awesome judgment, there can be no thankfulness for God's still more awesome mercy. Without remembering where God has led us, we can in no way give thanks for how far we've come. Remembering is the key. But remembering is, well, hard and sometimes painful. Forgetting, on the other hand, is like rolling off a log. When I was in school, I heard a lecture from a very famous defense attorney. And he explained that time was the defense attorney's best friend. The more you stall, the more time you end up, the more witnesses were likely to forget exactly where they were, what they saw, who they talked to. And of course he's right, my memories are notoriously short. In today's 24/7 news cycle, stories often come and go before they ever really sink in. I think that maybe our attention spans are just shorter. Not too many generations ago, a typical Sunday sermon easily ran 30 to 40 minutes, right? Yeah. Actually, in the first American Lutheran hymnal, there was a rubric specifying that the sermon shall be no less than 45 minutes. Now don't get nervous. But today, preachers are warned that if you can't get it done in under 15, or better yet, close to 12, you better hang it up. Maybe we watch too much TV. Maybe we got a bad case of information overload. Maybe we're just too busy to remember. But when Moses prophesied to Israel, put his finger on something a little closer to home. As Israel was about to enter a good land, a land of flowing streams, with springs and underground water dwelling not in valleys and hills, a land of wheat and barley and vines, and fig trees and pomegranates, Moses also warned, when you have eaten your fill and have built fine houses and live in them, and when your herds and flocks have multiplied, and your silver and gold is multiplied, and all that you have is multiplied, then do not exalt yourself, forgetting that the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery, do not say to yourself, my power and my might have gotten me this wealth. Nearly 3,000 years later, amid civil war, Abraham Lincoln echoed much the same prophetic warning when he proclaimed the National Day of Humiliation, Fasting, and Prayer. He wrote, "We have grown in numbers, wealth, and power, as no other nation has ever grown, but we have forgotten God. We have forgotten the gracious hand which preserved us in peace, multiplied and enriched us and strengthened us, and we have vainly imagined in the deceitfulness of our hearts that all these blessings were produced by some superior wisdom and virtue of our own." That was 160 years ago, but tell me, does it still preach? Yes. We are prone to a kind of cultural amnesia. We forget who we are. We forget whose we are. We forget where we came from. And we forget wherever it was we thought we were going. The wealth given to us becomes the wealth that deludes us, turns us cold and arrogant and contemptuous about us. That's why exhortations to be thankful just don't matter. You can tell people to be thankful until you're blue in the face. And when the store doors open on Black Friday, all that thankfulness will disappear quicker than you can coach your pen into the nearest ATM. The cure is not in just being thankful, but in remembering. And we are, as God's people, above all things, a community of remembrance. We remember in order to grieve our wrongs. We remember in order to give thanks for our blessings. We remember in order to be remembered. That is, in order to be restored to the wholeness that we have sacrificed the filthy lucre and unrighteous men. Remembering the night in which he was betrayed, we come to this table for our risen Lord to remember us as the body of Christ in this world, the salt of the earth, the light of the world, city set on a hill. Because as Jesus told us, remember, I am with you always. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
You may rise for the hymn of the day. What's the name? What's the number? 1063, and that is in the blue books of Creation 6, okay? Or maybe they're worth it. I don't know. You may rise. 1063.
Creator of heaven and earth, I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered in the Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into death, on the third day he rose again, he ascended into heaven, he is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Let us pray. Generous God, we thank you for the legacy and the gift of the Church. Make our proclamation clear, our generosity bold, and our community rich in welcome. We raise grateful hearts for the body of Christ where we find belonging. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Creator of the earth, the bounty of creation reveals your abundant love. Provide safety and shelter for all wildlife. Save us from the waste of natural resources. You raise grateful hearts for the earth, our home. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of all nations, make all tribes and lands places where justice and inclusion is realized and celebrated. Protect any who are vulnerable and feed all who are hungry. We raise our grateful hearts for civil rights and just views. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Healing God, you see us and are moved with compassion. Attend to those who are sick or dying. Surround with love all who are lonely and despairing. And comfort those in need, including Chuck, Sam, Pam, Adam, James, Carol, Bill, Joe, Christine, Joel, Andrew, Bill, Earl, Skip, Robin, Danny, Tammy, Carolyn, Diane, Julia, Bill, Donald, Madeline, Ken, Jean, Judy, Judith, Cliff, Ryan, Harold, Arlene, and our homebound family and friends, and all those who we name aloud or in our hearts. We raise grateful hearts for your loving kindness. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of the welcome table, you gather people to be shaped by your word. We pray for ministries that notice and respond to human needs, food banks, shelters, community resource centers, and our local ministries, including Project of Easton, Safe Harbor, the Third Street Alliance. We raise grateful hearts for these organizations. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
God of life. We raise those who have died to new life in Christ. We raise grateful hearts for the lives and faithfulness of all your saints. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
O God of all righteousness, you know the history of injustice that has shaped our lives and the world we live in. Awaken us to your justice as we lament the broken relationships and violence around the world. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We offer our spoken prayers and those held in our hearts, trusting in your mercy, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Peace be with you always. You may be seated as we turn to our choir.
Let's pray.
God of all goodness, generations have turned to you, gathered around your table, and shared your abundant blessings. Number us among them that, as we gather around these gifts of your abundance, and give thanks for your rich blessings, we may feast upon your very self, and care for all that you have made. Through Jesus Christ, our sovereign and servant.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right to give our thanks and praise. It is our duty and our joy that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior, Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, by his glorious resurrection, opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Thank you.
There is a place for you at the banquet. Come and feast at Jesus' table. Thanks be to God. You may be seated.
In the Middle East and in Ukraine, there is information in your bulletins. Now
gives to any of the many humanitarian crises now afflicting so many people. Volunteers are encouraged to help with Sunday morning worship videos, and with no experience necessary, you can visit with either Monica Weiss-Dolan or Ruth Thomas about that. I will be off this Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday for Thanksgiving with my family. I pray that your Thanksgiving gatherings are joyful and refreshing. Everybody say amen.
Amen.
Okay. Are there any further announcements from the congregation? Yeah, Bob.
I'd just like to remind you that the 2024 contribution envelopes are available in the narthex.
Thank you, Bob. And again, I'm so grateful. I'm really grateful for all of you. Where somebody else got an announcement?
Yeah.
That's it.
Thank you.
you of the fellowship time and the gathering of our worship. The love of God, go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.